Oh my God, that smells good.
Yeah.
Hi guys, I'm Billy Mack, and welcome back to my lighthearted cooking show, Ringham, where we teach you how to make traditional firehouse meals, and I push my merch, Pally Scally Hats. Do you remember last episode when we made spaghetti sauce, and it was the best spaghetti sauce known to mortal man? And we made extra sauce just for tonight, because tonight we're making the pizza pies. So for those of you that can count, this is part two in a two-part series. Stay with me. Okay guys, if we're gonna make some pizza pies, we better start making some pizza dough. This is how we do it. I like my dough with just a little bit of garlic taste in it. So what I have is 3/4 of a tablespoon of garlic salt going in. 1 tablespoon of sugar. 1 package of yeast. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna add 3/4 cup of warm water, about 100 to 110 degrees Fahrenheit. You don't wanna fry the little bastards, you just wanna warm them up. Put that in there and let that sit for a minute. Let it all mix up and start to work, and then we're gonna add 2 cups of flour. Let's give it a little spin. That's good. Now let's add our flour. 2 cups. Use aught flour. All right, we'll put it on low and let that mix up. This will take a few minutes. Then what we're gonna do is take this and we're gonna let it set in a bowl at room temperature. We'll cover it up and let it sit for about maybe an hour and a half. Well, it's time to take our pizza dough out and roll it out. Some of my viewers asked me, they said, hey, where'd you get that cool cutting board? And this came from Redstone Woodworks and Milling in Grand Junction, Colorado. And this is just a piece of ponderosa pine that was going to be firewood. And we counted 178 rings in this. So I just turned it into a really cool cutting board. And then, as I always said in my videos, if you're seeing my videos and you have a product that you want me to use, send it to me. And I just received this custom-made black walnut rolling pin from Big Ass Rolling Pins in Pagosa Springs, Colorado. It's beautiful. Give them some work. All right, let's make some pizza dough. First, we'll throw a little bit of flour down on the cutting board. Take our pizza dough out. Throw it on there, get a little bit of flour on it so nothing sticks. We'll start working it. All right. Put a little flour on this rolling pin. Let's make some pizza dough. Roll it out there. And the really cool thing about this cutting board is we're going to just take this thing once we get the pizza dough rolled out, and we're just going to roll it right over onto our pizza pan. Wow, that's coming out beautiful. Flip it over. Roll it out. This is coming out beautiful. And you can smell the garlic salt that I put in there. You can smell the garlic coming out of this dough right now. Perfect. Okay, and we'll get our pan out and lay it out on it. That's going to be a big one. All right, now here's another little life hack that I like to use. I take my pizza pan, put a little bit of olive oil on it, spread it around, a nice coating all the way around it, And then I like to take some breadcrumbs, put them on the pizza pan. This is Italian style breadcrumbs. Roll it around on there like that. And that coats it. And when you put your pizza on there, it'll release from there real easy. And the little kernels in there will let air get underneath there and give you just a beautiful, nice crust underneath. And I'll take the excess over here and I'll just go put these in the sink. Okay, there's our pizza pan. We're gonna set it on that board right there. Roll it over. Perfect. All right, let's load this bad boy up. Now, if you'll remember the best spaghetti sauce known to mortal man, we had extra. So we've taken it out of the refrigerator. And we're gonna spread it on there. And if you'll remember, we had all the ingredients in it. We had ground hot Italian sausage, Polidori link sausage, fennel, oregano, parsley, basil, all of that, mushrooms, onions, it's all in here already. There's a bay leaf, we'll take that out of there. Let's put it down on your dough. Get it all around there. That's why we made extras for these pizzas right here. A little more here. Beautiful. And then we can load it up, and you load it up with all the ingredients that you would like. Here's extra Polidori sausage that we had. We've sliced it. We're gonna put it on there. Oh yeah. This is gonna be a supreme pizza. Then I like black olives. Put some of those on there. Spread them out evenly. And then fresh cut mozzarella cheese. Don't use that pre-grated stuff. That has chemicals in it to keep it from binding that aren't good for you. So spread this around. We're gonna give ourselves a bunch of mozzarella cheese. Yeah. And then something else that I like to put on there. We've already put dried basil on a pizza, but I've chopped up some fresh basil. Not much of it, just spread it around a little. You might even like some pepperonis, some sliced pepperonis on there. Put some of those on. I've preheated my oven to 475 degrees. We'll put it in there until all this cheese melts. Boom. All right, guys, let's cut into this. Oh, man. That smells so good. You know what time it is. Hey, Pazzano, ring him!
That's so good. Mm. Wow. Manja.
All right, guys, thanks for watching my show. Stay with me next episode because what we're going to do is make some scary, spectacular charcuteries just in time for Halloween. Thanks for watching. Subscribe. Go to my Pally Scally website. Buy a hat. Just enjoy food. See ya. Back in old Napoli, that's more.